You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Linder, your host, and I have another frequent flyer here today on Greater Brockton. I have Paul Engel, our library director.
Hi,
welcome,
Mark.
Paul. Good to see you.
Thank you. Good to see you.
We talked the last time you were here about all the different events that are going on in the library during the summer, but there are more.
Absolutely.
There are more. There are always things going on at the library and outside the library.
Right.
So let's do that first. The okay. farmers market during the summer, the library is going to have a presence there.
That's right. We are providing the children's entertainment mm-hmm. for the rest of the summer, all the way through till September. So that means there's seven more programs that we're running. This Friday, they're all at 11 a.m., 11 to noon, and mm-hmm. then at noon the music starts. This Friday we have the magician...
Chris Levitier.
Chris Levitier, thank
yep.
you, Mark.
Okay.
And I think after that is the storyteller who was here who kicked it off.
And it's all on the library
website. It's all on the library website.
Which is brocktonpubliclibrary.org.
Yes.
Okay, so you can look for that. And it's on the posters mm-hmm. as well for the farmers market. They have a Facebook page
yeah,
too.
Yeah.
So it'll be there. So there's children's entertainment, there's music, mm-hmm. and there's food.
There's a food truck. And there's a food truck.
I wasn't here last week. I was away, and I heard about the food truck already, and we've been waiting for food trucks in Brockton. Not to disparage any of the local restaurants, mm-hmm. but just something different.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I think it's fun. Frederick Douglass has been making the rounds in Brockton, the
yes.
Frederick Douglass Traveling Exhibit.
Right.
And it's coming to the library on the 24th.
Yes.
And there's a program.
Yep.
That's going to go along with it. It's been over at City Hall. Mm-hmm. Forget where else it's been. I kind of follow Lynn Smith on Facebook, and she tells me where it is. I just don't remember.
Right.
And Frederick Douglass was very integral in Brockton history.
Mm-hmm,
we have Frederick Douglass Avenue, which was High Street. There was a Liberty Tree there. There's mm-hmm. a clone of that Liberty Tree over at the Historical Society that we are cultivating over there.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Plymouth County 4-H helped us when the tree got chopped down because it was unsafe.
Okay.
We took seedlings or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
And there's another one someplace else in an undisclosed location in case anything ever happens to that tree. And Lynn had been talking about maybe doing a little brick walkway on Frederick Douglass Ave about it once we see the downtown redevelopment starting to happen.
Nice.
There's children's programming at the library, there's teen programming
there
at the library. How's the teen room going?
Teen room's going really well. We unfortunately lost the woman who was in the teen room. She had to move back to Florida for family reasons. But we're really looking forward to refilling that position and with somebody who's just as eager to work with the teens. We still have a lot of programming. We still have a teen Facebook page.
Right.
And so she's really launched a lot of stuff, and we are, through the grit and determination, keeping that stuff moving forward.
So that's a posted job right now?
It is.
Okay, and it'll be on the city website
yes.
at, the Brockton...
Actually, I might be ahead of myself. I don't think we post.
Well, it will be posted.
By the time
okay.
this gets aired, we'll
okay.
be
but,
on.
Okay, but you got to be a Brockton resident
yes.
to work at the library.
Yes.
But we want someone that really likes to work with teens,
mm-hmm.
okay? We got everything going on there. We got children's, we got teens,
mm-hmm.
we got literacy, we have...
That's right.
English as a second language,
mm-hmm.
something for everybody
yeah.
over there. We have a historical room,
mm-hmm.
a children's room, a reference room,
mm-hmm.
all the traditional library things.
Yeah.
And you're talking about, down the road, one of the things we talked about when you got hired is some more music at
Absolutely.
The library.
Well, we're going to be doing a music series this fall. We're going to start with a little bit on the easy side. We're going to do six concerts throughout the year.
Mm-hmm.
And then we could expand on that as we move forward. But yes, absolutely. I want to do more music there. The art gallery is a perfect place for music. And,
yep.
And of course, we have the Lingos Auditorium if we need a bigger space, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
And we want to thank the Lingos family for their continuing support of the library. Dr. Lingos was my predecessor mm-hmm. back in the day. Not my immediate one, but he was the chair of the board when I joined the board 20
okay.
years ago. And his family still contributes to us and still supports the library. I went to school with his daughter, Tamara, and they love the library. We always, I miss him dearly because he was such a special guy. And so was his wife, the whole family.
Yeah.
People love the library. We did very well this year. We have the support of the city council.
That's right.
Support of the mayor, support of the legislative delegation, and who doesn't like a library? I mean, for God's sakes.
It's a great it's a great space. I mean, and the branches are great, too, and we're opening them up more hours this fall.
More hours the fall, yeah. And the main is going to be open.
The main is going to be open.
Another night.
Yep,
And not just another night, but we're going to go from 8 to 9.
That's right.
Which is really important, because then if someone comes home from Boston, they get home, they have dinner with their family, then they can come to the library and not be rushed.
Right, and that's going to be really good for our programming.
Absolutely, because and then we have community groups that use the library, the meeting room and the meeting spaces, and just good things are happening. You know, stuff is digital now, so you can plug into that. I got to talk to somebody about the digital yearbooks that
digital
the Boston
yearbooks.
Public Library did. We believe it or not,
we have about half of them done. We got to finish that.
I got to find out if you have 79. If you don't, I'm going to move it up on the list, because we have a 40th reunion coming up.
Okay, yeah.
And what we're talking about doing is our name badges are going to be our picture. God help me, because it's me with hair, Paul. I'll have to show you. I didn't have a ponytail, but I had hair. 79, long time ago. Full disclosure. Full head of hair, and then I went to Florida, and it all
fell out.
It's crazy. So if people want more information, they go to the website.
Uh-huh.
They come, and you guys get brochures, you get newsletters, you get Facebook.
Yes.
Best thing that ever happened, I think, is to
Twitter
add Facebook and Twitter. Mm-hmm. I know I saw Gary Highlander's coming in the end of August.
He is, the end of August, to talk about Frederick Douglass.
Right.
And Lynn Smith will be introducing
him. I already saw her promote it. That's
I
saw it. I saw it before the library Facebook. She said she was interested, and there you go. And that helps, okay?
Yeah.
And to have Instagram, which is more modern than old folks like me use.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay. Twitter is you know, obviously, you know, and, you know, there's just something for everybody over there.
Yeah.
And it's a nice space to be in. I think we all, as a community, did a good job to get it to happen. It has a name. We're working on working that out so we can publicize that it's the Thomas P. Kennedy. It's the Brockton Public Library Thomas P. Kennedy Main Branch.
Right.
And Tom grew up in Ward 2 around the corner on Winthrop Street, and his mother, the senior center's name for us.
Right.
And Tom helped us when we went to get the money to expand the library to make it handicapped accessible. Mm-hmm. Tommy was a state rep at the time before he was a state senator and before we lost him. And he loved the library.
Yeah.
And I know we have our legislators that do some of their constituent meetings at the library.
Absolutely.
And the fact that we're going to open the branches a little bit more, that's important, because you got the branch on the east side right near the East Middle School, right near the Downey School. You got the branch on the west side right near the high school and West Middle School. And, you know, we're going to keep building.
Yes, we are.
Okay? We got a good board. We got a full board now.
Full
we
board.
Got two more board members. We have Phyllis Ellis.
Yep.
And we have Lisa O'Donnell. So now we're up to the nine.
That's right.
We lost Nancy Smith after she passed. And, you know, and we even have people that were on the boards and involved come back and help us and support us and everything. So we got a minute left. I'm going to give you about 45 seconds.
Okay.
Anything else you want to promote?
Found out today that we were awarded an LSTA grant, Libraries and Services Technology grant, for the children's room. We're going to introduce coding for kids between the ages of 5 and 5th grade.
That's where it starts.
Yep.
Coding, and we have the makerspace, and we have everything.
Yeah.
So thanks for being on.
Thank you, Mark.
Good to see you. Always a pleasure.
Always.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.